this video, I'm going to teach you the parts of this 16 Prospector canoe and the outfitting of it for moving water. This is a 16-foot Prospector canoe made out of Kevlar Duraflex. So the Prospector canoe is a classic model of canoe first made by the Chestnut Canoe Company in Peterborough, Ontario. It's awesome for moving water. These are the parts of it. This is the yoke. It's for portaging, putting it on your shoulders. This yoke has a really nice deep contour, so it fits really beautifully on your shoulders. It's very comfortable to carry. This aluminum bar here is the thwart. Gives the canoe its shape, keeps it from collapsing in on itself. These are the seats, really comfortable bench seats, lots of room underneath for your feet when you're kneeling in there. These are the gunnels, the sides. They're made out of aluminum. And then at either end of this canoe, there's built-in flotation tanks. So it helps keep the canoe from sinking when it's full of water. So now I'm going to show you the outfitting of this canoe. We've outfitted this canoe for moving water for the river. So it's got a painter, which is a rope that floats, tied onto this handle here, this aluminum bar, tied on with a bowline. The painter should be 1.5 times the length of the canoe. So 16-foot canoe, it should be a 24-foot long painter. They're at both the bow and the stern. Also got a throw bag here. The throw bag is tied on with a bowline there, I just stick it right here. In other canoes, you can drill holes here and put a bungee cord, and then the bungee cord holds the throw bag like that. It's put here for doing tow rescues, which is a moving water rescue that I'll show you in another video. So your throw bag tied onto the handle and then stowed right there. Another important thing about the throw bag, when it's tied to the canoe, make sure it's one of them that's rated for a canoe that can hold thousands of pounds, because a canoe full of water is heavy. Don't use the person rescue ones because that rope will just snap. I also have a baler. Pretty much every baler I've ever seen is homemade out of, this one used to be a bleach bottle, I think. Laundry detergent bottles work good too. So that's the baler. It's got a rope so that we can tie it on to the canoe. Just scoop the water out. What is this canoe missing for moving water outfitting? That's right, flotation. So in the middle of the canoe here, we would normally have a big balloon looking thing full of air. That's flotation in case we capsize and it starts to float away so that it doesn't sink. It costs about $150 and there's a global pandemic, so we don't want to drive to Abbotsford to buy it yet. But it's just, you gotta have flotation in your canoe when you're in moving water. This particular canoe, we got it with this wilderness outfitting rigging straps that hold the flotation in. Not every canoe has that, so you just tie it in with rope. Gonna talk about life jackets now. You gotta have a life jacket for moving water and flat water. This is a PFD, personal flotation device. The difference between that and a life jacket is a life jacket's got that thing on the collar that keeps your head above water. So if you smack your head on a rock and you're knocked unconscious, a life jacket will keep your head above water. PFD won't, but it's more comfortable on a hot sunny day especially. So things I got on my life jacket. I got this carabiner that's a part of a pin kit. So if I needed to rescue my canoe, if it was full of water, I could sort of grab that throw bag and put this on a tree and maybe pull it to shore like a pulley. I got a whistle in here. Signaling device. It's got two pouches for nice rocks that you find on the beach. Kind of counterintuitive for a flotation device, but rocks are cool. You might have noticed that on my canoe, there's tons of ropes and straps and stuff. pretty easy if it capsizes to get your foot or arm tangled in there and stuck underwater. So I have a knife on my life jacket so I can cut myself free if I'm trapped underwater or if my partner's trapped underwater. I kept losing my knife because it falls out of this sheath really easy, so I used a boot lace to tie it on. It's got, my life jacket has a strap at the bottom here that should be tight enough that it's under my rib cage, so it doesn't, I can't pull it up, so I'm not liable to slip out of my life jacket. And then my life jacket goes floating downstream with no body in it. And it's a bright color, and it's got reflective stripes here. So if someone's looking for me at night, they can find me.